emergency. What service did you require, please?
More quick! Anybody, just get help!
Where are you calling from, sir?
Kai Hara! Phone box! It was this roaring noise! A big white light in the sky! And then these invaders started killing us!
Hold on, sir. I'll connect you with the Department of Internal Affairs.
No time! They're after me!
Hello? Is there anybody there?
What do you think, Minister?
Call a full-scale invasion on that, sir. I'll phone the forces. Fighters, frigates, foot-sloggers.
Perhaps that could all be a bit showy. I think this is a job for real men.
Just stop right there. Stop.
I think you'd better kill him, Barry.
Geez, he could be Ministry of Works or something.
He's moving too fast.
This is definitely your last chance.
If I'm not the poor bastard that's got to clean that up. Jesus.
Stick all the bits of brain in a plastic bag, Barry.
We'll need them for analysis.
No bloody way, mate. You can come down here and do that yourself. You're the gung-ho scientist.
Oh, all right. I'll be down straight after lunch, but at least take a blood sample.
No need. I'll just wring my strides out. Oh, well, at least we got one live specimen.
Yeah. Seen anyone else about, Barry?
No. The place is completely deserted. They're probably all dead. That's at least 75 people.
Jeez. I just hope we're in time to save the world.
Well,
I just hope you got it right this time.
No doubt about it, Barry.
I've been watching the skies. And do you know what the skies did?
They pointed
They pointed at this place.
Why can't aliens be friendly?
There's no glowing fingers on these bastards. We've got a bunch of extraterrestrial psychopaths on our hands. Like a visit from a planet full of Charlie Mansons. They've wiped out a small town for starters. It's my guess they'll go on to something bigger next time. Christchurch, Wellington.
Auckland?
Yeah, well, that wouldn't be so bad.
Well, you'd better contact the others, Derek.
They should be in range now. And you'd better tell them to keep an eye out for someone who could be heading this way.
Who?
A collector.
There's some appeal on. There's envelopes stuck on all the doors, and today's collection day.
Hey, there's something that's just occurred to me too, mate.
What's that?
That joker you topped a while back. He might have friends.
I'd keep me ice skin if I were you.
You needn't worry. I'm not stupid, thanks.
Elevator music for headbangers.
Frank, Ozzy, are you there?
Yeah, we're here, mate. But could you use a proper call sign? There could be people listening.
There's nobody for miles, Frank. Besides, I don't think whispering's gonna help.
He's got a point there, Frank.
What do you mean nobody for bloody mile? I thought you were in Kai Horror.
I am in Kai Horror, and I was right all along. They've done the entire town.
Who's done the town?
Extraterrestrial low-lifers.
And guess what?
We've caught one of the bastards.
Me and Barry caught him loping over the hills this morning, just like he owned the bloody place.
Huh?
Now do you believe me?
Jeez, look, Derek, just keep him there.
You got him secured?
Bloody oath.
Right, now don't touch him. We'll be there in 45 minutes. And look, whatever you do, don't harm him. No physical violence. And another thing, Derek, keep a careful lookout. There could be more of them about.
Well, there was, down on the beach.
Oh, well, look, don't go near him.
It's a little late for that now, Frank.
What?
It wasn't me. Barry shot his head off. He had the Magnum.
I knew it was a mistake to issue weapons.
We're a government department, not a paramilitary unit.
Yeah, the Astro Investigation and Defense Service.
Wish we'd change that name.
Due to the potentially dangerous hazards involved.
All right. At least you managed to convince the minister.
Aren't you interested in this joker we caught then?
Of course we are, Derek.
Right.
Stay
stay where you are, then, and I'll give you an eyewitness description of this intergalactic wanker. Well, I would describe him as sort of human-shaped. He's got jeans and a blue shirt on.
Oh, Christ, isn't that the bloody farmer?
Yeah, but there's something strange about him, though. Like he's got a screw loose or something.
It is a bloody farmer.
Yeah, Derek strikes again. This isn't going to be another false alarm like the Menace Street invasion alert, is it?
Well, how do you explain the disappearance of an entire township then, Frank?
Oh, the Kiwi Jonestown, of course, that's it.
Drinking beer laced with cyanide from little polystyrene cups.
Yeah. Okay, Derek, just do me one favour.
What?
Try not to make him extinct before we get there.
Out.
Christ, what a dork. How the hell did he get in this team?
Your plans for conquering the universe, eh? My friend, the Astro Bastard, time for talkies. By the time my colleagues get here, I want to have you babbling in some extraterrestrial language. Now, in case you don't want to do what you're told, I can always encourage you by hammering this cold steel into your fibula. It'll sure poke a nasty hole in your marrow, mate. We'll get the old ball rolling, eh? Now, what are you dirty who is doing on my planet? Time for the old count of 10. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Come in, Derek!
What? Oh, jeez.
anything, Derek? Come on!
Yeah, look, geez, Barry, you've got awful timing. What?
Just listen to me. You've got to get out of there fast. Five of those blue shirted freaks are coming up. They heard their mate screaming.
Don't run.
Well, get up a tree or something.
Yeah, look, just don't worry. I've taken precautions.
Oh, shit.
Thank you. Eat lead, sucker!
Going a little bit over the top, was he?
Nah, this'll do the trick. Nobody will be coming out this road.
But the newest nuclear reactor's in America.
Yeah, but it could have been an explosion on one of those Springbok warships.
Frank! Lossie! Frank! Lossie! Come in!
Yeah, what is it, Barry?
Jeez, you guys! We're in trouble this time! It's really hit the fan!
Derek's wiped out five of these alien jokers. The place is like a bloody abattoir.
But where's Derek now?
Well, he's turned his toes up, guys.
Took a dive off the bloody cliff.
He's popped his rivets.
Poor Derek. Who's gonna look after his Avery now?
Yeah, birds were the only thing he could relate to.
Off the road until I call you back. I'm gonna head off in the direction that alien joker was going when me and Derek caught him this morning. He must have been going somewhere. They probably got a base up there or something.
They don't need a base. They could just beam themselves down from their spaceship.
Well, maybe they haven't seen Star Trek, Ozzy.
Oh!
Bye-bye.
That's my overtime up to date. Here, do you want to do yours?
Hey, Frank.
Yeah, what is it, Barry?
Where exactly are you two?
About 5 miles from Kaihara.
Yeah, well, just stay put. I think I might have spotted something, and I'm moving in closer.
Finished us?
We've got trouble.
Good one.
Right, we're on our way.
I suppose you're wondering why you're soaking in Reggie-delivered secret herbs and spices. Tomorrow we're having you for lunch. You're the exotic new taste sensation. Human flesh is it. You are going to be the first bit of meat. chance to get our teeth into since we arrived. So we're going to treat ourselves to a feast with you as the main course. Quite an honor, really. We'd better leave so we can get some sleep. I'll have the air dredge. I want to suck his brains out.
Go back to the office. Get reinforcements.
That'll take a day.
And a rest. Take 2 days to do the bloody paperwork.
Yeah, and by then that collector bloke could be dead.
If he's not already. Look, go on. After midnight.
A gun to Ozzy.
Yeah, but don't forget about his personality disorder.
Open season on ETs, Frank.
Remember, Ozzy, get in quietly, get out quietly.
Well, I certainly hope that is the case.
Thank you.
Sorry, Oz. We won't be needing that.
Bloody Perry. Bastard.
What are we gonna do if we're spotted, Frank?
Well, I guess we shoot the bastards.
My turn for the Magnum.
I just wish we didn't have to wear all this crap.
Yeah, but you know what the rules are. When we work undercover, we have to remain faceless.
Oh, I get it. Just in case we kill a lot of innocent people.
Don't you forget, Oz, we're only authorized to use violence when there's a threat to the planet Earth.
And the moon.
Yeah, and the moon. There you go, Oz. Stick this stuff on. We ought to have a look around. If these are aliens, they might have parked a spaceship somewhere around here.
They might have come in a telephone box.
Well, let's just get that guy out. Then we'll try and contact base and give them the code words for invasion.
The bastards have landed.
The bastards have landed.
Take off for home tomorrow. I'm sure you'll be pleased to be leaving this shitty planet. In the meantime, I must impress upon you the importance of remaining in human form. No matter how awkward, uncomfortable, and ugly it makes you feel, we are so close to success that we must take no chances.
Right. Looks pretty quiet. Probably all gone to bed.
Jeez, I hope not.
Right, synchronized watches. 12:01.
Check.
Check. Let's go. We're on triple time.
The sad news is that we will be heading for Neelignod with six of our co-workers in a state of permanent death. They died today, murdered by some real arseholes. Robert escaped their clutches and reported back to me.
My God!
What the?
My God! The blood!
Shit!
Somebody could get killed in here.
Vacuum the floors, clean the windows, and all the boxes must be loaded in the freezer first thing in the morning. We've been wasting our time unless we can present samples to the Neelignod Fast Food Authority. Isn't it amazing how you could fit a whole town of humans into a few cardboard boxes? If you slice off the fat, it's the value of keeping your knife sharp in your mind.
Jesus, guys. Derek was right. This is what's left for the people from Kaihara. They're in those boxes. Get them, Barry.
For God's sake, guys, keep it quiet.
Shut up, Oz.
I just cleaned it, but...
Oh, that's gross.
Gee, they come to bits, easy.
Get rid of it.
The old magic's still there.
What are you doing, Frank?
I'm gonna go in there and find out what the hell's going on. Here, he was carrying this. Yeah, stay here.
Up, Ned. Past week has been difficult, and I would like to say how proud I am of you all. The manner in which you conducted a very tricky slaughter operation has been a real credit to you, and indeed to the whole Crumbs Crunchy Delights organization. Your paychecks reflect the gratitude of the company, I can assure you. I don't think we'll have any more trouble. However, we will be handing these around later. I am certain that when the Homo sapient taste takes the galaxy by storm, as it will, Crumbs Crunchy Delights will be back at the top. McGiabolo's fried moon rat won't know what hit them. All the livestock we need are right here. 4 billion of them. Right, Robin. Once the Fast Food Authority have checked the samples and issued the mass slaughter permit, this grotty little planet will tremble under the full might of the Lord Crumb restaurant chain. Within a year, a giant mincer will descend from the sky, the sun reflecting from its silver bits, and no army on Earth will be able to stop the Noddy Burger machine. Just before we leave tomorrow, we will have a little party dinner with fresh local meat. It's my show of appreciation to you all.
Christ, you'd never believe what I just had to do.
Did you have to drink some chuck?
Come on, let's find a guy and get out of here.
Good night, Boyle. Night, Reg. Oh, Robert. What a lovely little mossy.
Uh-huh.
Thanks.
Get dressed.
Door. Got in quietly. Stay here.
Come on.
How many did you see?
About 8 or 9.
Nah, there's heaps more. That's one less. Ever been in a gun battle before?
No.
Me neither. But this one's gonna be big, eh?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Frank!
Thank you.
I bet that cleared his sinuses. That's another beer you owe me, Oz.
Go that way.
You reckon?
Too right. Where the hell's Barry?
Frank. You go on. I'm gonna go back and stop those bastards. We're supposed to be going for help. You go! Besides, you're not gonna be back in time to stop them.
Come on.
Thank you.
the nearest phone, call head office.
Hi, my name's Giles Copeland.
Yeah, I'm Barry. Let's go.
Got another one here too.
Wankers.
For God's sake, Oz, put that thing down. Let's get in there and hit the leader. With them.
Ah.
work! Bastard!
Jesus! He's gone apeshit!
Bastard!
Let's get the hell out of here! Here you go, mate. I don't smoke.
Bastards.
Thank you.
Very well, really. But then these pricks try to take us on, but we soon fixed them. Lost all our scummy third class laborers, but I've got some great samples. I'll be home in about 20 minutes. Hold the line.
Coming to get you, bastards!